Dino Buzzati was an Italian writer, painter, and journalist. Born in 1906 in the San Pellegrino quarter of the north Italian city of Belluno, he was the son of Giulio Cesare Buzzati, Italian jurist, whose own father, Augusto, served in the Court of Appeals, and of Alba Mantovani, whose other son, Adriano Buzzati Traversa, was a well-known geneticist. He was educated at the Ginnasio Parini in Milan and studied law at the University of Milan. In 1928, he began working as a journalist on the Milanese daily Il Corriere della Sera. During the Second World War, he served as a war correspondent journalist under the Royal Italian Navy in Africa, witnessing the war in Ethiopia. His most famous novel of Kafkaesque military befuddlement, A Tartar Steppe, appeared around this time in 1940. He adapted some of his stories into plays, which proved highly popular, such as A Clinical Case, while also directing plays, ballets, and operas. In 1966, he married Almerina Antoniasi, and in 1970, he won the Mario Messai Prize for Journalism. Buzzati died from cancer on 28 January 1972 in Milan. Catastrophe, The Strange Stories of Dino Buzzati, was originally published in English in 1965. That edition is so rare nowadays that the cheapest copy I could find costs about £93 without postage, and the other ones go between £160 and £300. In his introduction to the Echo reprint of the book published in 2018, Kevin Brockmeyer relates his own futile attempts to obtain said edition, a long martyrium which left him convinced that the book didn't in fact exist. The stories in this collection hover on the edge of the Kafkaesque with a keen streak of the conte cruel. Sometimes you will likely think Buzzati is too cruel to his characters, and indeed Buzzati can sometimes be as savage as Charles Birkin at his most raw, in such tales as Just the Very Thing They Wanted or Something Beginning with L. The supernatural and fantastic is present occasionally in his stories, but Buzzati relies on bizarre occurrences happening in the real world for the most part, such as in The Collapse of the Bariverna, detailing the horrible destruction wrought by an unsuspecting man moving a single pole from the side of a massive building. Sometimes Buzzati does slightly frustrate you with his brevity. The title story concerns a curious situation. A train going one way, while seemingly the entire countryside is fleeing in panic in the opposite direction for reasons unknown. However, Buzzati simply decides to stop the story the moment the train does stop at its final destination and someone screams out somewhere. Similarly, we have the case of The Monster, where a maid unexpectedly runs into a monster in the attic. Everyone involved with the house denies this to be true, but suddenly there's a lock on the door and the key is nowhere to be seen, and then the story just sort of ends. The Epidemic is a slightly silly story, with the chief of a decryption unit having to come to terms with the idea of those of his absent staff members being targeted by a special kind of influenza, one that only affects people critical of the government, all the while not feeling well himself. The March of Time is a higher concept story of the passage of several years during the course of a single dinner. Meanwhile, we have The Alarming Revenge of a Domestic Pet, which is another victim of Buzzati's brevity. We have a young lady whose insistence not to be served by a weird deformed bat that her aunt keeps as a pet leads to the bat getting insulted and cranking a lever that launches bombs all over the city somehow. Seven Floors is a fine Kafkaesque story of a patient's losing battle against the wiles and intrigues of a private sanatorium. Its one negative is, however, that you can tell very easily where it is going. The Slaying of the Dragon concerns a count and his associates going on an expedition to a remote forest to hunt down what is rumored to be a dragon living in these remote parts, ending in tragedy, though perhaps the ending is a trifle underwhelming. The Opening of the Road is a wonderful Kafkaesque story of a delegation travelling to inaugurate a new road and being unable to find the city the road is supposed to lead to. The Scala Scare is another tale of this sort, with all the guests at the premiere of a new opera frightened out of their wits and unwilling to leave the opera house because of rumours that the revolution had broken out in the meanwhile. The Egg is a wonderful little story, despite all the death in it, of a poor mother's quite literal miraculous victory over the combined armed forces of society at large, all for the sake of her daughter's well-being. And Yet They Are Knocking at Your Door is the story of a wealthy family whose house is slowly eaten away by the coming flood, with the lady of the house refusing to admit it despite all the proof. The Enchanted Coat concerns a man discovering his new coat miraculously produces 10,000 lira notes from its right front pocket, and he deliberately abuses it until he is forcefully confronted with where exactly the money comes from. The Saints is an unusually positive story for Buzzati of the worries and woes of a new saint no one ever prays to. Hopefully the recent republication of Catastrophe will lead to more of Buzzati's fiction being available in English.